Myself, Mamata, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Vidyavadhaka College of Engineering, Mysore. I will be handling the subject kinematics of machines. And the subject code is 18ME44. In this kinematics of machines, I will be handling the first module. And in that kinematics of machines, the learning objectives of this module are here to understand the concept of machines, mechanisms and related terminologies related to the machines and the mechanisms, and also to expose the students to various mechanisms used in mechanical engineering. These are the learning objectives. Next, we will move on to learning outcomes. And at the end of the course, the student will be able to understand the knowledge of mechanisms and inversions of different mechanisms in this first module. Next, we will discuss different topics in this module. In that, we are discussing the definitions related to the basics, the tire links, then joints, kinematic pairs and kinematic chains, then what are the machines and the mechanisms. Then we will be discussing degrees of freedom. Then we will discuss Grashof's criteria and inversions. And inversions of different mechanisms we will discuss. In that, four bar mechanism, inversion of single slider crank mechanism and inversion of double slider crank mechanism. And also we will discuss different quick return motion mechanisms, straight line motion mechanisms and intermittent motion mechanisms. Okay, first we will start with this kinematics. And what is this kinematics? Okay, here we are discussing about the mechanisms. Particularly we are discussing about the mechanisms. And what is mechanism? Mechanism means if a number of bodies are assembled in such a way that the motion of one causes the constrained and predictable motion to the others. That is called the mechanism. Okay, in this mechanism, it converts the motion and modifies the motion. It transmits the motion and modifies the motion. And a machine is a mechanism or a combination of mechanisms which, apart from imparting different motion to the parts, and also transmits and modifies the available mechanical energy into the desired work. That is called the machine. For example, we will consider that IC engine. Okay, in that IC engine, it converts the motion and modifies the motion. It transmits the motion and modifies the motion. Okay, in this study of mechanisms, it involves analysis and synthesis. And then what is analysis and synthesis? Here in the analysis is the study of motions and forces concerning different parts of an existing machine mechanism. Okay, in the analysis, we are doing the analysis on the existing mechanism. And in that, we are discussing what is the displacement, velocity and acceleration of a mechanism or a machine. But in the synthesis, it involves the design of the different parts of the mechanism. That is called the synthesis. Synthesis means to generate or to produce or to create or design. It is called the synthesis of mechanism. And in this synthesis of mechanism, different types of synthesis, that is the type synthesis, number synthesis and dimensional synthesis. In the type synthesis, we have to select the particular mechanism for the application, that is that which type of mechanism we are using. Then number synthesis. In the number synthesis, we will discuss how many number of links there in the particular mechanism. that is called the number synthesis. And dimensional synthesis. In the dimensional synthesis, we will discuss what are the dimensions of the links. Or for example, if we consider the four-bar mechanism, what are the lengths of the links? We need to find the length of the links. That is called the dimensional synthesis. We have to find the lengths and also we have to find the input and the output angles. That is called the synthesis of mechanism. Synthesis of mechanism means we have to design the mechanism, new mechanism, or we have to create a new mechanism, depends on the requirement or the depends on the application. But in the analysis, we are doing the analysis on the existing mechanism. That is called the analysis. This is the difference between the synthesis and the analysis of mechanism. In kinematics, it involves both synthesis and the analysis of the mechanisms. Okay, in your in this subject, you will be studying both synthesis and the analysis. And in the second module and the third module, you will study the synthesis analysis. In the second module, analysis of mechanisms. For that, you will study that some geometrical methods or the graphical methods to find the displacement, velocity and acceleration of the mechanism. And in the third module, second part, you will be studying that synthesis of mechanisms. Okay, that for that we are using the Fredenstein's equation to find the dimensions of the links or the length of the links. You will derive that expression, Fredenstein's equation for four-bar mechanism and Fredenstein's equation for the slider crank mechanism. Okay, in this kinematics, we are dealing with the relative motion of different parts of a mechanism. And here we are not considering the forces producing the motions, forces acting on the mechanism. We are not considering the forces acting on the mechanism in this case. And also we are not bothered about what is the material used for the particular mechanism or the links. We will discuss only the relative motion of the mechanism. Okay, we can use any material for that particular link. Okay, it may be a metal or it may be a plastic or it may be a wood. Depends on the application, we will select the material. But here we are not bothered about that material which is used for the particular mechanism. But we are dealing only the relative motion of different parts of the mechanism. That is called the kinematics of mechanism. Then, in that kinematics, when we are discussing the kinematics, there are two parts we have to discuss. That is the kinematics part that I already told you. We are considering only the relative motion of different parts. And also there is a topic called dynamics. Okay, it involves the forces acting on the mechanism, or it involves the calculation of forces impressed upon different parts of a mechanism. Again, in the dynamics, it may be a static or it may be a kinetic. Static means the forces acting on the dynamics is further divided into two parts, that is the kinetics and the static. Here, kinetics is the study of forces when the body is in motion, whereas in statics, with forces when the body is in stationary. That is called the kinetics and the statics. Okay, in this subject, we are not discussing the forces acting on the mechanism. We will discuss only the relative motion between the parts, and also we will discuss the analysis of the mechanism, that is how to find the displacement, velocity and acceleration of a mechanism of different links in a mechanism, particular link. We can find it using the in this subject kinematics of machines. And also here we will I already told you we will discuss the geometric point of view to know the displacement, velocity and acceleration of a part of a mechanism. Next we will move on to this, what is mechanism? Okay, I already told you that mechanism it is having a number of bodies assembled in such a way that the motion of one causes constrained and predictable motion to the other. Or it is a combination of rigid bodies assembled to transmit and modify a motion. That is called a mechanism. Then what is rigid body? Okay, rigid body means there is no deformation in this. Distortion is zero in this rigid body. That is called the rigid. This mechanism is made up of a number of rigid body or a combination of rigid bodies or assembled in such a way that to transmit and modify a motion. Okay, we will consider one example on that. For example, all we are familiar with this mechanism, slider crank mechanism used in IC engine. Here, this is a slider crank mechanism. In this slider crank mechanism, there are four links in a slider crank mechanism. Link 1, it is a frame. This link 1 is a fixed link. And this is link 2 is a crank. And link 3 is a connecting rod. And link 4 is a slider. Here, this slider crank mechanism, this is a single slider crank mechanism. Okay, only this slider is also a link. And there are four links in the slider crank mechanism. Here, it converts reciprocating motion of the piston into a rotary motion of a crank. And here, the torque is produced is used to move the vehicle. Here, this is the cylinder. And this one is a slider, is called the piston. Here, piston is called slider here in this. And this is the connecting rod. And this is a crank. Okay, here, this slider moves from top dead center to the bottom dead center. That is, it will reciprocate and it transmits the motion from top dead center to the bottom dead center, and also it converts the reciprocating motion of a piston into a rotary motion of a crank. That means it converts or it transmits and modifies the motion. That is the function of the mechanism. And we can give many examples for that mechanism. Okay, that typewriter, that is also a mechanism. And also we know that mini drafter. Okay, when we were studying, we were using mini drafter for doing the drawings. Okay, that is also a mechanism. And these are the some of the examples. And clocks, watches, etc. These are the some of the mechanism. In each of these, the force or energy provided is not more than what is required to overcome the friction of the parts, and which is utilized to just to get the desired motion of the mechanism and not to obtain any useful work. But here, in this slider crank mechanism, we are using that to obtain useful work. Okay, like this we may list many mechanisms. Okay, this is one of the mechanism which converts reciprocating motion of a piston into a rotary motion of the crank. It transmits the motion and modifies the motion. Okay, next we will move on to the types of constrained motion. What is this constrained motion? Okay, in this there are three types of constrained motion. They are completely constrained motion, incompletely constrained motion, and successfully constrained motion. Then what is this completely constrained motion? Okay, this is an example for completely constrained. This figure shows that it is a completely constrained motion. Then what is completely constrained motion? In this, when the motion between two elements of a pair is in a definite direction, irrespective of the direction of the force applied, the movement of the link has a particular direction. That is called the constrained motion, completely constrained motion. For example, we will consider this square bar in a square hole. Okay, it will only slide in that Okay, this is this square bar is sliding in this square hole. And this is also one of the example for this completely constrained motion. Here there is a shaft and a here there are two collars at the ends, and here we can only rotate, it will not slide inside that. Okay, that is completely constrained motion. Then incompletely constrained motion. What is this incompletely constrained motion? In this incompletely constrained motion, when the motion between two elements of a pair is possible in more than one direction and depends upon the direction of the forces applied. For example, here in this case, okay, this is a shaft in a circular hole. Here the difference between this and this is, here there are two collars at the ends, here there is no collar in this shaft and the hole. Here we can rotate this shaft inside this hole, and also we can slide in this inside this. Okay, but here in this case, in the completely constrained motion, we can only rotate this shaft, we cannot slide inside that. That is the difference between this completely constrained motion and incompletely constrained motion. Then we will move on to successfully constrained motion. What is this successfully constrained motion? Here, in the successfully constrained motion, when the motion between the two elements of a pair is possible in more than one direction, but is made to have motion only in one direction by using the external means, it is successfully constrained motion. For example, a shaft in a bearing, this is a thrust bearing, a shaft in a thrust bearing may have vertical motion apart from rotary motion. Here only the vertical motion is possible in this case. And here, due to load applied on the shaft, it is constrained to move in that direction, and thus is a successfully constrained motion. Similarly, a piston in a cylinder, okay, in the last example we have, this is a piston in a cylinder. It will only reciprocating in this cylinder, but it will not rotating, because we are using the piston pins, due to the constraint of the piston pin, this will not rotate, it will only reciprocate in the cylinder. Okay, these are the some of the examples for this successfully constrained motion. Okay, these are the different types of constrained motion. Okay, completely constrained motion, incompletely constrained motion, and successfully constrained motion. Then we will move on to the basics related to the mechanism. And link, this is a basic element in a mechanism. Okay, this link is a rigid body or a resistant body with rigid connection preventing their relative motion is known as a link. Okay, please remember, link is a element. This is a basic element of any mechanism. Okay, that is called the link. It may be a rigid body or it may be a resistant body. And this different types of links. In the types of links, binary link, ternary link, and quaternary link. Here, depending upon their ends on which revolute or turning pairs can be placed, based on that, these links are classified. Here, this is binary link. Here, there are two ends. That is called the binary link. Ternary link, it is having three ends. 1, 2, 3. This entire thing we will consider it as a single link. Okay, here if it is this 1, 2, 3, all the three ends are in the same link. This entire thing we will consider it as a single link. Ternary link, three ends. And quaternary link, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four ends in this link. Depends on these ends, we have classified this as binary link, ternary link, and quaternary link. And these ternary and quaternary links are called the higher order links. And these links are the first or the basic element in any mechanism. Next, we will move on to the joints. What are these joints and different types of joints? Joint means joining two links. That we call it as a joint. In this joint, different types of joints we will discuss: binary joint, ternary joint, and quaternary joint. In binary joint, if two links are joined at the same connection, it is called a binary joint. This figure shows that it is a binary joint. This is one link and this is another link, and we are connecting these two links at this point. This is called the joint. This point is called the joint. Binary joint, two links are joined at the same connection, is called a binary joint. Similarly, ternary joint. Here in this ternary joint, there are three links connected at this point, at the same connection. If three links are joined at a connection, we call it as a ternary joint. Here in this ternary joint, this is 1, 2, 3. There are three links, and this is a common point or a joint for these three links. And quaternary joint. In this quaternary joint, there are four links. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, if four links are joined at a connection, it is known as a quaternary joint. And these are the different types of joints. Okay, there is a difference between the links and the joints. Okay, don't confuse with that. Link is a rigid body or a element in a mechanism. But joints are, we have to connect number of links. Depends on the number, we will call that as a binary joint, ternary joint, and a quaternary joint. Okay, next we will move on to the kinematic pair. The first element in a mechanism is a link, basic element. Next is a kinematic pairs. What is this kinematic pair? We know that pair means two. Okay, we are joining two links having a relative motion between them. That is called the kinematic pair or a pair. Minimum two links are required to form a kinematic pair. Joint of two links having relative motion between the links. That is called the kinematic pair. And types of kinematic pairs. And these kinematics or pairs are classified based on the nature of contact, then based on the nature of mechanical constraint, and based on the nature of relative motion between the links. Okay, under this first category, based on the nature of contact, lower pair and higher pair. Then what, based on the nature of mechanical constraint, there are closed pair and unclosed pair. Then based on the nature of relative motion, they are classified as sliding pair, turning pair, rolling pair, screw pair, and spherical pair. These are the different types of kinematic pairs based on these each headings. First, we will take this first one based on the nature of contact. And based on this nature of contact, they are classified as lower pair and higher pair. In this lower pair, there is a surface contact between the two links or between the two elements in a link. That is called the lower pair, surface contact between the two links. In higher pair, there is a line or point contact between the two elements. In this lower pair, both the links having the same type of surfaces. Okay, that is the nature of this lower pair. Here in higher pair, one link may have a point contact and other may have a surface. That is the difference between the lower pair and the higher pair. Okay, we will see this example for this lower pair and a higher pair. Here, this is a bolt and nut. Here they have both bolt and nut are having a same surface contact. Okay, here there is a surface contact between the bolt and the nut. This is the example for the lower pane. And here this is a cam and follower. This is the example for higher pane. Okay, this is the follower. It is a knife edge follower and it is a cam. The contact between this cam and the follower is a line contact or a point contact between these two elements. Okay, this is one link and this is another link. Okay, here we are considering in this there are two links. This bolt is considered as it has one link and nut is considered as another link. And here the follower is considered as one link and this one cam is another link. There are two links in this. And here there is a line or point contact between these two links. This is called the higher pane. And here there is a surface contact between these two links. This is called the lower pane. These are the examples, some of the examples for lower pane and higher pane. Then we will discuss, based on the mechanical constraint, they are classified as closed pair and unclosed pair. And what is this closed pair and unclosed pair? Here in the closed pair, okay, here we will take this example. Here in a closed pair, this cam is one link and this is another link. And this is completely enclosed in this link. Okay, let me consider this as link 1 and link 2. Here, this link 1 is completely enclosed in the link 2. And if you want to separate these two links, we need to break the component, any one of the link. We have to destroy any one of the link to separate these two links. That we call it as a closed pair. Then unclosed pair or open pair. It is also called unclosed pair or open pair. In this unclosed pair or open pair, we can easily separate these two links. I already told you, this follower is one link and the cam is another link. There are two links in this cam and follower. Here, if you want to separate these two, we can easily separate without breaking the component. Open pair. This is called the open pair. We can easily separate these two links in this. Okay, this one, link 1 and link 2. This is called unclosed pair or open pair. Please remember, in a closed pair, if you want to separate the links, we have to destroy or we have to break any one of the link in a kinematic pair. But in this open pair, without breaking the links or the components, we can separate these two links in a open pair. Okay, then next category is based on the nature of relative motion. Based on the nature of relative motion between the two links, they are classified as sliding pair, turning pair, rolling pair, screw pair and spherical pair. What is this sliding pair? Here, if two links have a sliding motion relative to the other, they form a sliding pair. Here, we will consider example. Here, this is the example for sliding pair. Here, a rectangular rod in a rectangular hole in a prism is a sliding pair. This is the sliding pair. It is moving. Here it is a rectangular. It may be rectangular or square hole, and the square or rectangular rod. The cross section of this rod is square or rectangle, and it is sliding inside that rectangular hole. That is example for the sliding pair. Then turning pair. What is this turning pair? Here in the turning pair, when one link has a turning or revolving motion relative to the other, they constitute a turning or revolving pair. Here this one, this is a turning pair or a revolving pair. This one, this is the hole. Here there is a shaft and we are rotating inside that hole. That is the example for the turning pair. Or we can consider another example also. In a slider crank mechanism, which we have discussed already, all pairs except the slider and guide pair are turning pairs. A circular shaft revolving inside a bearing is a turning pair. Okay, and that is the example for this turning pair. In the turning pair, when one link has a turning or revolving motion relative to the other. Next, rolling pair. Okay, in the rolling pair, when the links of a pair have a rolling motion relative to each other, they form a rolling pair. Okay, the example, a rolling wheel on a flat surface, ball and roller bearing. These are the some of the examples for a rolling pair. Then we will move on to the screw pair, or this is also called as helical pair. Screw pair is also called as helical pair. In this screw pair or helical pair, if two mating links have a turning as well as a sliding motion between them, and they form a screw pair. Okay, let me here both sliding and rolling, turning, both sliding and turning. Okay, that is the helical pair. This is the screw pair or the helical pair. When we are rotating, it will rotate and also it will slide, both sliding and turning, or turning as well as the sliding motion between the links. Okay, here this screw is one link and this is another link. Okay, both sliding and turning motion between the two links, that is called the screw pair or the helical pair. This screw pair is also called as helical pair. Next, the last one is the spherical pair. Okay, in this spherical pair, one link in the form of a sphere turns inside a fixed link. It is called the spherical pair. And we can give example ball and socket joint. That is the example for the spherical pair. This one is the ball and this one is the socket. This here, this figure shows that ball and socket. Okay, and also here we have mentioned the degrees of freedom for this particular kinematic pair. That we will discuss it later. What are degrees of freedom and how we will consider the degrees of freedom. Okay, this is a spherical pair. This spherical pair is having one link. When one link is in the form of a sphere, turns inside a fixed link. This one is a fixed link, and this ball and socket, this ball is rotating inside this socket. These are the different types of kinematic pairs. Okay, the kinematic pairs are classified based on the nature of contact, based on the mechanical constraint, and based on the nature of relative motion between the links.